Like the rest of the country, Las Vegas is in an economic slump, but billions of dollars are being invested in new or expanded resorts along the Strip.
The venerable Sahara is one of the only properties to escape the implosion trend so far, but drastic changes are coming there.
The new owners say they have grand plans for the Sahara. They granted their first TV interview to the iTeam's George Knapp. So what are they planning?
Well, big stuff, new stuff, flashy nightclubs and trendy restaurants, but the most impressive thing about these new owners, I would say, is their respect for Las Vegas history and the Sahara's special place in that history. They have no intention of wiping all that away, even as they pour piles of money into reinventing the property.
Some kids, you know, like train tracks, and some kids like Legos, and for me, this was just Disneyland, my Disneyland. It was amazing.
Sam Nazarian made his first visit to Las Vegas as a teenager and knew immediately it was his kind of town. Now, he and his partners own one of the oldest and most iconic properties on the Strip, the Sahara Hotel, last of the Rat Pack joints, where the Beatles stayed and the mob played. Nazarian's company, SBE Entertainment, is no stranger to glitz, money, and celebrities. SBE owns a string of highly successful nightclubs, upscale restaurants, and boutique hotels. They even have a movie division. That hip Hollywood customer base is only part of what they hope to lure to the Sahara.
Nice.
We're not going after Beverly Hills and Manhattan. We're going after Scottsdale, Austin, San Bernardino. That's our client base. That the people that come to L.A. that would not want to visit us here.
The sidewalks of the Strip are littered with the fleeced corpses of rich guys who figured that since they knew how to gamble, they could run a casino. Nazarian and his partners say they know this lesson well. They're almost reverential in their approach to Las Vegas, have sought out the input of veteran casino figures, and vow to find a niche that works for everyone.
I don't think we're under any illusion that we're going to revolutionize anything. We're not in any way trying to say that we're going to be better than anybody else or smarter than anybody else, but we want to add something different. And I think we want to be part of that fabric and that DNA of the Strip.
An investment of more than $300 million is still a gamble, but it looks like a good one. The economy's in the tank and business on the Strip is down, but in the year since SBE bought the Sahara, the fruits of nearly $20 billion worth of investment have been sprouting all around the place on the north end of the Strip. Someday soon, this will be the hottest real estate in town. The Sahara wasn't in disrepair when it was sold, but it's not on a par with the mega resorts, not yet anyway.
We wanted to make sure that we bring some added value to our customers right away. We spent a few million dollars in really upgrading the hotel from new carpet, wallpaper, new uniforms for our staff, new menus in every area.
Company executives have added the newest machines, modernized the pool, spruced up the place, and have reached out to local customers, but know it'll take a lot more money to make the property competitive. They aren't spilling all their secrets yet, but have revealed at least one tower will be imploded and replaced. The name might be changed, but even if the Sahara itself is gone, they plan to keep the name alive in some significant way as they reinvent the resort. The Sahara has assets after all. A major boulevard carries the name. Its gargantuan suites are marketable for their history. This one, for instance, is where Elvis romanced Anne Margaret while filming Viva Las Vegas. Keep the history and market the future. That's what they have in mind.
We're proud to be here, but we're humbled to be here. I mean, there's greatness in town, and you can't come to this town. It's this very small network of people and think that you know everything. You just have to learn, and you're a student of Las Vegas, and every day you learn something new.
From what we talked about all around Joan the Flamingo, all the way through the Howard Hughes days, and all the way through the Bill Bennett days, and the Murren days, and the rise of Harrah's. And we're just trying to really try to learn, and at the same time add our little taste.
SBE and its partner Stockbridge Equity Fund are keeping the hotel's NASCAR feature and the roller coaster for the time being. They did say they've hired famed French designer Philippe Starck, the father of the boutique hotel concept, to create the look for the new Sahara. And given the current business environment, they're in no hurry to put all these pieces into place, but they hope that changes real soon. We'll have some links on our website if we want to learn more. One little story that Sam Nazarian told me, he said when the story first broke that he had bought the place, Kirk Kerkorian saw his name, and because it ends in IAN, he thought, he called him up and said, hey, nice to have another Armenian on the Strip. And he was reluctant to tell him what the deal was, that he's not Armenian, but he did finally confess.
Yeah, that's something you might want to play
up. Get a call from Kirk Kerkorian anyway.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you, George.
Sure. The Bureau of Land Management's planning a wild